Cristinotto, this is your new Pro Tools life. Okay, editing. So what I've done here, zooming out, remember, command, I don't know what the hell that is, but you know what it is. Zooming out, this is my super sweet drum track that I made. You ready? Here it comes. One time. Times. So, this up here is the drum track. Just like yours, I've got it set up. So here's the kick and the overheads, and I put the drum bus up here, and then the click is over here, and here's your overdub tracks here with the overdub drum bus here. So what I did was I was playing the sweet drum beat, and then I fucked up. So I'm gonna mute my overdrum, actually. I fucked up my fill, bro. Check it out. But then I came back in pretty damn solid. So what we're going to do is fix that. I'm going to show you how to do that. First of all, I made this little track down here. It's hard to see. I'm going to make it smaller so you can see it. This guy right here. This is a cue track. I just made an extra mono track and I said this into the microphone. Let's see if we can get a better level on that. Okay, so when I hear that, I know that I'm about to change whatever it was that I fucked up. So that, you know, I don't have to guess where the fuck it is if it's a hard cue. So we fucked up right here. Zooming in. Fucked up. Here's the fill. So I re-recorded this, by the way. This is an overdub. I re-recorded this. What I'm going to do is erase the part that I fucked up, which is here. This right here is the kick drum that is super solid when I come back in after I fucked up my fill. And this, it's solid up until here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this, just inside somewhere, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to delete it, highlighted all the tracks. Now I'm going to take this, which is inside that, doesn't really matter. I'm going to command X, which is cut. Oh wait, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to grab it with the hand, not the little stick, with the hand. Grab it, push it straight up there. And be sure not to wobble around and whatever, because then it'll be in the wrong place. If you do, Control Z and does it. So you take it straight up, right there, it's in the exact same place. So now we're going to put it together. And what I'm gonna do is get this little guy, not this little guy. I need this guy. I'm gonna push Shift, because it's gonna get both of them. I'm gonna pull it over until it's here. And actually this right here is a snare hit. And if we listen to it, it's not gonna sound that great. It's gonna sound just as fucked up as before. So we're actually gonna cover up that snare hit, which is right here. And we can do that, just highlight it again, push Shift, highlight with the hand, and then grab it with this little symbol. We're just gonna cover it right up to there. And then we're gonna zoom back, click right here, and I'm using the stick, not the hand. When you go around, you can click anywhere, but if you see the hand, it's gonna do that, it's gonna piss you off. So we're gonna listen to it from there. It's pretty clean. Pretty fucking clean, if you ask me. I think there might be a little pop though. Ah, that's clean. That's super clean. So we don't have to crossfade. We're going to crossfade, though, over here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to zoom in. And you notice it's on the front, but I want to go to the back. So I push the right arrow, and it goes to the right to the back of what I'm trying to do. And now I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to hold down Shift. with this guy. I'm going to bring it over right up close to this, not overlapping the bass drum. That's a big bass drum hit. We want to go just before it so that you get the whole attack on that bass drum. And oh, it looks like we have a little extra attack on the bass drum. So let's listen to that. Sounds pretty good. By the way, I have the whole, this, I muted the drum bus down here for the overdub track, so we're not hearing any of this stuff at all. We're only hearing this guy up here. So we're going to pretend, I did such a good job, but we're going to pretend that there's a pop here. So I'm going to show you how to do the crossfade. You can't, I don't know how to do them both at the same time. But, so the crossfade, you just grab this guy. Not this one or this one, but this one. This is a crossfade. And you just click on it, it'll automatically highlight it, and you just pull it out. See this little X comes around. But you just want to go as little as possible. And then if you do it there, you probably want to do it here too. So make a match, right? I'm going to zoom in on it. So there we go. They're pretty close, you know, whatever. This is just play along shit, so. So I'm going to zoom out, listen to it. It's pretty solid. But if it wasn't solid, oops. If it wasn't solid, what we would do is go up to it, and you can just grab with this tool this side and just move it, and you can make it a little bit bigger. Oops, I fucked that up. Has to be on this side. You can make it bigger if you want, if you need to. And you'll just find out where that clip is, and it'll get rid of it. Now, my beautiful track, I'm gonna bounce it. First, we're gonna erase all this extraneous bullshit that we don't need. We're gonna go to the beginning of the track, which is right here, actually. I'm gonna get rid of that too. Beginning of the track, we're gonna, oops. I'm gonna zoom in. Here's the beginning of the track. So this is our first beat, first drum sound that's gonna happen. So we wanna go back 4. We're gonna grid all this shit now. Go up to the grid. It's up there, you know where it is. All this, by the way, was done in the slip mode, not the grid mode. So we're gonna go to grid, back to grid, and we're gonna find 4 clicks before this guy, which I think is here. What? Okay. So now, here's our click. This is our click track. And we're gonna get the little pointer tool. Well, your click should be on mute, by the way. The wave, you know, right there. Make it say mute. You get the little pencil instead of the hand, so now you got the pencil. And you find your start point. The start point was here. 1, 2, 3, 4, go. So on go, I'm just gonna bring the pencil here. Now it's muted. So this is on, this is off. So now I should hear the metronome go until the first beat. So it goes. Works. I got my snare all ringy, just like you like it, buddy. Okay, so now we're gonna go back here. I have the cursor here, 4 beats before the drums come in. I'm gonna highlight all the way to the end there, after the drums are out. And at that point, you push Alt, Command, B, and Alt, the one that they're right next to each other, Alt, Option, key, then the one with the little apple, Alt, Option, Alt Command rather, and then B, and you got your bounce. And you're gonna go format stereo interleaved bounce, and then name it fucking rad, and then save it. And then convert it to an MP3 and send it to me.